that your dear wife could not be here to assist you by giving away the prizes, but we ask you to kindly convey to her our best wishes and our thanks for allowing you to be here with us. The year under review was one of mixed fortune. As a Thomian family, we experienced both success and failure, the thrill of victory and the agony of defeat, and our shares of joys and sorrows. But through it all, we stayed the course. And wherever and whenever we failed or fell, we picked ourselves up, dusted ourselves off, and got back to work. But looking back, we can be satisfied that we have done our best. The very brief report in your hands, included with the prize list, will give you a snapshot of some of our achievements. The school magazine of 2016 that some of you have received will have more details. The results of our boys at public exams during the year have hopefully dispelled the myth that St. Thomas's does not focus enough on academic work. In fact, we are very happy to record that the results of the 2015 GCE ordinary level examination released in April and the 2016 GCE A level examination released earlier this year have been the best in recent years. The London NXL results of 2016 were also more than satisfactory. The statistics included with the prize list will show you just how well we have done. While 36 of our boys obtained 9 A's at the O level exam, 18 of our boys obtained 3 A's at the A levels, while a further 17 obtained 2 A's and 1 B, an all-time record for St. Thomas's. I am awarding a memorial prize in memory of the late Professor Dayasiri Fernando for the first time this year to the high achievers at the advanced level examination. We have also been informed that in the science stream, St. Thomas's has been ranked second at all item level along with Methodist College and Devi Balika Mahavidyalaya. Further, 3 of our boys, namely Siran Senvi Ratna, Sudharatra Arya Ratna and Jay Vikas, were placed within the first 30 at all item level, while Senar and Sundarata were ranked 8th at district level. I am also very happy to note that not a single boy failed all 3 subjects at the local A level, unlike in previous years, an indication that our zero failure policy is bearing fruit. I congratulate all our boys from the class of 2016 on these exceptional and outstanding results, and can only hope that success begets success. These results as a whole are a product of the collective effort of our dedicated staff and a group of hardworking and motivated students. I must also mention that much of the credit must go to my predecessor, Professor Ingrid Disoisa, who put in place a number of systems, including the zero failure policy, to ensure good results at public exams. We continue to be very concerned about the future of bilingualism and the number of subjects that the department permits our boys to offer in the English medium up to the O-level exam. The lack of a uniform policy on this matter has resulted in students studying for the local O-level exams in some international schools having a very unfair advantage over children in state and government-approved private schools, in that they can sit all subjects other than obviously their first language in English, whereas our children are only permitted to sit 5, and under very special circumstances, with permission having to be sought each year, a further 2 subjects. The argument given by the authorities that this is because international school students are registered as private candidates does not hold ground, especially when they are allowed to compete with our children on equal ground in some sports and other extracurricular activities. What happens to children whose mother tongue is neither Sinhalese or Tamil, such as children of mixed marriages or children of other minority communities in this country? On the other hand, we also continue to face the vexing problem of Sinhala and Tamil students losing touch with their mother tongue because they are studying so many subjects in English. While it is true that English is the language of opportunity today, it would indeed be sad for Sri Lanka if Sinhalese boys could not speak or understand Sinhala or Tamil boys their Tamil. St. Thomas's College has always encouraged the sound working knowledge of our national languages, and we ignore them to our loss. We need to instill a sense of pride in our national heritage while we do also teach our voice to the citizens of a globalized world. St. Thomas takes holistic all-round education very seriously. We provide some of the best facilities among schools for 26 sports and games. Throughout 2016, we rejoiced in victory when we beat our rivals, and we learned when fortune frowned on us how to take defeat. Despite having unexpectedly lost the Royal Tomian cricket match, our first 11, led by an outstanding Tomian sportsman, Sakita Jayatilakar, left the field with their heads bruised but not. Cheered on by the Tomian Legion, a support base that was created in 2016, many other sports teams of the school took on our friendly rivals in a bid to make it very clear that one loss was not going to dampen the Tomian spirit. And as a result, in rugby, sailing for the third successive year, in soccer, in tennis for the third successive year, and in water polo for the fourth successive year, we beat Royal College convincingly. The first 15 rugby team under Pandura de Silva did well to win all their trophy matches and also emerged runners-up in the All-Ireland Single League Tournament. SPC also became champions of the All-Ireland Sevens after 22 years. Two of our allies were selected to represent Sri Lanka in the under-18 rugby team by one of them, Navin Hena Kankanamge, was chosen to captain the team. Our under-19 basketball team, led by Adrian Gunawardena, became champions of the Sri Lanka School's A division after 16 years, while our under-19 tennis team under Sebastian Sanzoni emerged public school champions after 23 years, as well as Sri Lanka A division All-Island champions, and brought much glory to the school. Our young sailors formed 50% of the Sri Lanka national team at the IOTA sailing event held in Sri Lanka. A number of our water polo players formed the Sri Lanka team at the South Asian Aquatic Championship events hosted in Sri Lanka. Our captain Ashane Francis has the further distinction of captaining the Sri Lanka team at this event. I am also very glad to report that athletics has also started a significant comeback. The fastest 100 meter runner under 15 in all of Sri Lanka in 2016 was the Tomian, K.P. Kulasinghe. A very notable achievement given the number of schools taking part in athletics. I must also continue to maintain a very high standard by their outstanding achievements at district and national level. At St. Thomas's, we believe sports to be a necessary and vital part of education, and we will never compromise on this. I see the coaches also as teachers who have a very important task in this age of cutthroat competitiveness, where even parents forget the true purpose of engaging in sports at school level. It is regrettable that more often than not, parents and old boys forget that our boys are not professional sportsmen and push them to achieve at the cost of things that are far more valuable and lasting. For us at St. Thomas's, winning is not everything. And I have repeatedly said, we must not try to win at all costs or at any cost. We need to focus rather on guiding our boys to enjoy their sports, to develop a passion for them, and above all, for the youngest age groups to get their basics right in a culture of discipline, self-belief and right values. Needless to say that teaching them true sportsmanship and how to face both victory and defeat is also crucial. Success will naturally follow. As such, we are building all our sports from the youngest age group upwards, so that never again will we need to headhunt talent from other schools or poach good sportsmen to ensure that our teams win all the tournaments. I know that some consider this too idealistic, but I'm afraid that's how it will be on my watch. Chromians also continue to excel in their involvements in the 40 or more clubs and societies that exist for their benefit. 2016 witnessed the inauguration of 4 new clubs and societies, the History of Archaeo Club, the Gavel Club, the Cyclist Union and the Carnatic Musical Society, that have already proven to make valuable contributions to the life of the school. We also witnessed a number of unique events starting up, such as the English Literary Festival, where the relatively new Junior English Literary and Debating Society collaborated with the Faculty of English to organize an event which exhibited the literary, dramatic and oratorical skills of the students in the lower and middle schools. The 4 religious societies continue to be engaged in developing spirituality and encouraging social witness in different ways while ensuring that morning prayers were conducted for each community of faith. The service clubs continue to engage in social and community service activities and raise funds through the organization of innovative events and projects. The media unit, ICT society, radio club and photographic club continue to perform yeoman service to the school. All the clubs and societies organize their annual activities very successfully and maintain a very high standard of which we are proud. Getting students involved in running the school in a limited way is something that many schools around the world have found to be very useful. On my visits to schools abroad, I have come across this in different forms. Since 2015, the head prefect has been part of the college council that comprises all the heads of departments, and he brings to those fortnightly meetings the voice of the students. The tradition of the school prefects meeting regularly with the warden has also been revived recently. Additionally, a group of senior students handle leading general assembly by reading out notices and awards, etc. each Wednesday. But from this year, I have decided to also institute a student council that will bring together students of the upper and senior schools in a representative manner to discuss matters of concern to the students. This council will be chaired by the head prefect, who will then bring to the main college council any recommendations and requests of the students in terms of student welfare and school life. I am very confident that this will add to our tradition of empowering children and young people to express their voice and help to build much needed self-belief as well as school spirit. I am also happy to report that the Board of Governors has given me permission to enroll St. Thomas's as an affiliated member of the Woodard Corporation in England. The Woodard Corporation brings together schools founded by Canon Nathaniel Woodard in the 19th century on a high church Anglican foundation, as well as schools with similar ethos around the world. All Woodard schools have an outstanding reputation for providing academic excellence coupled with a strong Anglican ethos and tradition for pastoral care. Our application to be affiliated has been received favorably, and once we sign the agreement, we will benefit from a range of resources available to affiliated schools that will benefit the quality of education that we hope to offer here. This link will also provide opportunities for student and staff exchanges into the future. I felt the need for a structured and regular training and evaluation program for our teachers, and over the past year we ran some extremely valuable in-service training days for the teachers in their different sections. These sessions have dealt with important aspects of pedagogy, child psychology and other relevant topics. In addition, the teacher evaluation system has been implemented. We will be benefiting from the services of a Fulbright scholar shortly, who will assess our teaching and train our teachers throughout this year. All this will, I hope, lead to a better learning environment in the school. A week ago, proposals for a much-needed national policy on general education, including proposals for reform in the education sector, were presented to His Excellency the President by the National Education Commission. On that occasion, His Excellency made the following observation. When we look at the educational policies of the country, we see that policies haven't been implemented for the children to rise with self-help without relying on the school syllabus. Whether he intended to or not, the President hit the nail on the head. In referring to self-help, I hope that he is implying that what we need is less standardization of syllabi and more emphasis on critical thinking, creativity and self-expression. Over the past 30 years, there have been many reforms, but sadly the many attempts to have a cohesive national policy for education in this country that does not change with every change of minister, ministry official or government have not been successful. It is our hope that whatever proposals have been made by the National Education Commission, that they will be not only practical and positive in the right direction, but also result in students being encouraged to be creative and to think critically. Education reforms that only increase syllabus content or exchange one large syllabus for another are inadequate to answer the need of the hour. If we compare our present education system to those of some other countries like Sweden or Finland or Japan, we may be surprised to see some very stark and interesting differences. For example, in a 2015 study on the Japanese education system, we find that Japanese children lead the world in numeracy and literacy skills. How? Simple answer. Teaching in Japan is about the quality of the lessons, not the quantity. In our system, the quantity of the lesson is too much even for the 40-minute period that is assigned. The Finland and Sweden education systems, like Japan, go on the principle that less is more, or less equals more. We in Sri Lanka are not able to consistently stick to one system of education long enough to see if it actually works. We are constantly introducing new methods, ideas and initiatives. We keep adding more and more to our plates, sometimes without removing any of the past. We believe more is the answer to all of our education problems, not less. Everything can be solved with more classes, more homework, more assignments, more content, more after-school tuition, and of course, more exams. The result? More pressure, more stressed and demotivated teachers, more frustrated and burnt-out students, and more harassed parents. What we have now benefits the private tuition industry most of all, for obvious reasons. If the proposed reforms do not address this problem, there will be of absolutely no use. When we celebrated the 165th anniversary of the school last year, I realized that apart from the Bishop Chapman Scholarship and the name of one of the junior dormitories of the college boarding house, there is no official recognition of our revered founder, Bishop James Chapman. Described by Canada R.S. Disserum as that great and good man to whose faith we owe our existence. Unlike most church schools in our diocese that recognize their founder with a prize at the prize giving, usually the last on the list, St. Thomas's continues to award the Victoria Gold Medal for the best all-round boy of the school, and we will continue to do so, as this is a prize that has come to us from our earliest times. I have, however, been discussing at length with the sub-warden as to how best our founder can be appropriately remembered on an annual basis. And we decided to institute a new award from this year called the Bishop James Chapman Memorial Medal of Honor. The citation for this award states that it is awarded to the recipient for having exemplified and demonstrated the virtues of faith, courage, service above self, loyalty and integrity, and thereby fulfilled the founder's vision that the real end of all education is not to sharpen the intellect or improve the mind alone, but to form the character of the future man, to mold his habits, to fix his principles, and to make him good as well as wise. We felt it appropriate to make this award for the first time at this prize giving, as it is the prize giving for the 165th year. And the recipient I have decided on in consultation with the sub-warden is one we feel has fulfilled the criteria exceptionally well this year. I would like to ask the Lord Bishop to present the citation for this award, while I present the medal. To receive the Bishop James Chapman Memorial Medal of Honor for the first time, it is a great pride that I invite to the stage Vinetra Ashen Francis, current head prefect of the school. I feel a sense of pride and accomplishment. I want to take this opportunity to place on record my thanks to all those who have supported the school through thick and thin during the year under review and helped us to achieve our goals and stay faithful to our vision. I have to make special mention of a few individuals and groups of people. At the outset, I want to thank my bishop and the other members of the board, especially our secretary, Mr. Rajan Asivadam, the treasurer, Mr. Max Gunasekara, and the manager of the school, Mr. Ranganathan, for having been very supportive and encouraging at all times. The Old Wives Association and Parent Teachers Association have continued to partner on many ventures through the year with a great deal of commitment and enthusiasm. My thanks to the honorary secretaries Rohit Soisa and Ganapit Fernando and their executive committees and subcommittees. Remember, gentlemen, the reward for good work is always opportunities for more work. I must thank the many individual Old Boys and Old Boy groups both in Sri Lanka and abroad who supported the school in numerous ways. Thank you, one and all. I must thank my prefects for playing the crucial role of maintaining peer discipline and for the exemplary leadership they have offered the student body at all times. Every single member of staff at all levels has been a vital part of whatever success we were able to achieve during the year. I want to extend my thanks to all of them, especially those who share the burden of responsibility with me by serving on the college council as heads of sections and departments. I know that I am not always the easiest person to work with, but I thank them for their understanding and their patience with my eccentricities and my demands and for their loyal service to the school. Mrs. Meena De Silva retired as the head of the senior school in December after over 30 years of loyal and dedicated service to the school, and she was to the end a conscientious teacher who was devoted to her students. We wish her well in her retirement and thank her. Our chaplains, Father Amal Fernando and Father Roshan Mendes, continue to be my spiritual support while they offer counsel and guidance to so many students and staff as well. Their constancy and faithfulness has been greatly encouraging. Thank you both. My subordinate has been a tower of strength to me this year, and he has proved in a short time that my instincts in choosing him were not wrong. He is the most able lieutenant and has become my most trusted colleague. Our working relationship is in many ways similar to that of Obama and Biden. For example, like Obama and Biden, we also have developed our own method of secret codes, and often at crucial times in meetings, the subordinate communicates with me, and this either calms me down or encourages me or gets me back on track. I want to say thank you to him, and I look forward to our continued partnership into the future. As I close, I recently reread the sermon preached by Bishop James Chapman on St. Thomas's Day in 1849, as he laid the foundation stone for this school at Motwal. He expressed something that I want to echo and re-echo. In building for God, in working, in spending for God, we run no venture, we hazard no loss, we cherish no vague or uncertain hopes. Though unseen, when grounded on true faith, hope is never unreal. So while acknowledging all human contributions towards our growth and our success this past year, I must conclude by acknowledging the role of faith, the role that God has played, and affirm above all that nothing would have been possible without the grace of God. And so last but not by any means least, to him who by the power at work within us is able to accomplish abundantly far more than all we can ask or imagine, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you for your patience listening. God bless you and esto perpetua. Now my great privilege to welcome our chief guest, Professor Krishanta Mendes, to address us.
Before I came here, a good friend of mine gave me a three pieces of advice. He said, be serious, look like a professor and behave like a professor. Now, I'll try to be serious, but I have no clue as to how a professor behaves and how a professor should look like, thank God. My Lord Bishop, Warden, members of the Board of Governors, teachers, administrative staff, support staff, Tomians, old boys, ladies and gentlemen. While thanking the Warden for inviting me here today, I have to confess that it is the ultimate honor for me. But today is all about the prize winners. It is a day of celebration. I am very proud to be with you here today to share the delight and sense of fulfillment of the prize winners. Today is the day that you must thank your parents for their support, the teachers who forced you to work harder, they are all here, the administrative staff and support staff who helped you silently as well. Therefore, on your behalf, I thank them all, and on their behalf and mine, I congratulate you all. No one achieves success without the help of others. Now, in addition to education, this college builds character. Remember that character is more important than reputation. Character is what you are, whilst reputation is merely what others think of you. I am now a retired university professor. My background is in engineering. I will talk to you today on disruptions and the importance of education. We live in a world of technological disruption and change. Let me elaborate. We know that the world is full of many different technologies. When some of them converge, that is to say when some technologies overlap or come together, it weakens, transforms, destroys existing products and services. Now that is called a technological disruption. And it sometimes leads to social disruption as well. For example, the smartphone ambushed the phone industry. The smartphone is a result of convergence of many technologies. Computer technology, mobile phone technology, battery technology, touchscreen technology, and so on. Soon, electric vehicles will replace petrol vehicles. Eventually, they will be driven by onboard computers, without the need for a human driver. Robots and drones will be used in baggage handling, in the cleaning industry, for parcel delivery, in restaurants, hotels, and so on. Banks will integrate information technology, cyber security, and virtual currency in financial transactions. The list goes on. But such disruptions also result in opportunities, new products, jobs, and services. There can also be economic and political disruption. Life today is getting tougher and tougher. So when you leave school and join the workforce, I am addressing my comments mainly to the senior students. You can't rest on your laurels. You can't be complacent, even if you have obtained a university degree, even if you are the boss's son, even if you are the boss, and particularly if you are the boss. Companies have lost billions of dollars by not seizing opportunities when opportunities created by disruption. Therefore, you must continue learning. Then you will be prepared to face challenges created by disruption. But with my Lord Bishop's kind indulgence, I will relate a story about Adam and Eve. I'm not trying to challenge doctrine, my Lord, but today is Christ's Day after all. So, there is one disruption that might have been prevented. If you cast your mind back to when Adam and Eve were playing hide and seek in the Garden of Eden, and then the serpent came, and while Adam was hiding somewhere, the serpent came and tempted her, and Eve ate the forbidden fruit, the humble apple, discovered that Adam and she were naked, and started wearing leaves and barks of trees to cover themselves. Now, according to scholars, that was the first recorded disruption, and it was also the birth of the clothing industry. And it might have been prevented if only Eve had eaten the serpent instead of the apple. In many countries, snake flesh is eaten as a delicacy. So, it's not really a joke. Now, let me touch briefly on the concept of globalization. These days, everyone talks about globalization. So, what is it? Consider the story of Joseph Knox, also called Joe Knox, who lives in USA. As you might have guessed, Joe Knox had no job. So every day he goes around searching for a job. Here is a typical day for Joe. He is up early. His alarm clock is made in Japan. He has breakfast, he makes it himself. His fry pan is made in India. His coffee pot is made in China. He searches online for jobs, computer made in Mexico. Joe next shaves. His electric razor is made in Hong Kong. He gets dressed, shirt made in Sri Lanka, jeans from Bangladesh, shoes from Pakistan, wristwatch from Taiwan. Then he continues searching for a job in his friend's car made in South Korea. At the end of another wasted day, Joe relaxes for a while. He puts on sandals made in Brazil, pours himself a glass of wine made in Chile, turns on his TV made in Indonesia, and wonders why he can't find a job. How on earth can he find a job when most things and all his housewares are made elsewhere? So Joe blames the Obama government. Joe votes for Donald Trump. One might think that this story is a joke. My friends, it is not a joke, because there is a bust of belief in it. Why? Because Donald Trump won the presidential election last year, and as we now know, he caused a major political disruption. In fact, Donald Trump's triumph has given disruptions an additional dimension. So perhaps such disruptions should be called disruptions, or better still, disruptions. It's only a matter of time till the media get hold of these new words. Anyway, globalization is more complex than what Jonov's sad story is like. In general, globalization refers to the interconnectivity among countries. Globalization has resulted in a surge of ideas, goods, money and people across borders. Globalization generates prosperity and benefits millions. But such prosperity is not shared equally by people. That is the problem. Therein lies the problem. Also, although jobs are created in some countries, they are lost in other countries. So that economies have to be restructured. So what does restructuring mean? Simply put, it means finding new ways to stimulate the economy. For example, you can innovate processes in existing industries, grow more industries, focus on niche areas, develop new businesses, new business models, and so on. The effects of globalization are enhanced by information technology, and globalization sharpens the impact of a disruption, and that is why I talked about it. But some countries now want to close their markets due to populist belief. Many countries are now worried that Brexit, or Britain's exit from the European Union, and Donald Trump's protectionist policies might lead to dismantling of globalization. Well, we'll see. I will now talk about education, specifically continuing education. The future will bring relentless disruption. So you must grab opportunities. Boys, you must grab opportunities. Grab them from the jaws of disruption, if you must. And the way to do this, the only way to do this, is to increase your knowledge through continuing education. It enables you to keep abreast of current trends and practices. It also helps to gain fulfillment at work, even in your senior years, whether you are at the top or bottom of the ladder. For goodness sake, you don't know what you'll be doing in 10 years' time, in 20 years' time, in 30 years' time. You might even up here if you will be in crisis. Who knows? The point is that each of you must adapt to changes and grab new opportunities as they arise. Whichever field of work you are in, you must strive to gain expertise and achieve mastery. And that is the essence of continuous learning and its fulfillment. If there is no fulfillment, there is no point in learning. As the world gets tougher, learning becomes a winner. Learning is always a winner. There is no magic formula. There is no shortcut. You have to keep learning after you leave school. And you can do this through continuing education courses, adult learning courses if you like, which are available on various platforms and media. In Sri Lanka, they are available in Sri Lanka. Now, are Sri Lankans seizing all available opportunities to upgrade themselves? That is the question. In Singapore, where I live, it is a matter of survival. That is why the Singapore government is pumping about 1 billion Singapore dollars per year on continuous education and training. That is about 100 billion Sri Lanka rupees per year. And that goes mostly for subsidizing the course fees of Singaporeans who take continuing education courses. Look, my friends, I'm not boasting. Boasting is onerous, odious, and merely stating facts. Education is paramount in Singapore. The thing is that Singapore has no natural resources, and that is why Singapore is investing so much in its people. One might say that Singapore's passion for continuous learning is similar to Sri Lanka's passion for cricket. That is an observation, not a criticism of either country. I do follow cricket passionately. So, while we are on the subject, let me digress a bit to relate how cricket stopped the punishment by caning. You see, in those days, the warden's office was at the Thalassar, the last building over there, still there. And his office commanded a superb view of the cricket ground. Having watched batsmen like Michael Fitzgerald, Donald Reed, Anurag Thendulkar and others, wardens in those days were captivated by the square cut and the late cut. So square cuts and late cuts became a part of the caning repertoire. That is why caning strokes were called cuts. So a typical caning sequence might have comprised 5 square cuts rounded off with a well-timed late cut. Anyway, here's the story. This boy comes back from the warden's office with a pronounced limp, limping badly. So his friend asked him, Machan, mokka dhune? Machan, board mata khat saayak dhune? Ye, pahai mata rai dhune? Ye toh hamal? Mato cricket match at dhahan wale, warden match at jane lehen balen wale, warden ke late cut teka bima rai dhune. Hatta nissan dhe, mamre ikman to dhula. Ehnam bang, but nondi hain gogo. Dhuala ehnam kota warden ke dore kaku lagar dhune. It was after this incident that caning was abolished at college. Whether or not you believe my story, I am neutral on the issue of caning. Such things are best left for the warden to decide. Anyway, caning or not, the world is changing fast, technology is changing fast, job functions are changing fast, I am speaking fast, you too have to adapt fast to inevitable changes. No going. That's what life is going to be. I quote from a recent report issued by the World Economic Forum. I quote, due to the effects of disruption, an estimated 65% of primary school children will end up working in jobs which don't yet exist. An estimated 65% of primary school children will end up working in jobs which don't yet exist. That is due to disruption. And the world is full of them. Think about what that means. Now, dear prize winners, I am aware that you are waiting to receive your prizes. You will definitely receive your prizes even if Monday is not declared a holiday. But if Monday is declared a holiday, it will be a colossal disruption and it can be prevented. Because the warden is a very kind man. After all, he invited me here. I hope he won't regret it. So just give me 2 minutes and I'm done. My last topic is on trends in teaching methods. Many teaching trends are described in the internet or on the internet, whatever. But most are interactive. The general idea is to change from an instructor-based passive model to a student-centered active model. This is particularly beneficial in small classes. Emphasis is how you use what you know rather than what you know. Exactly what the board told you 10 minutes ago. Emphasis on is on how you use what you know rather than what you know. Because that will result in a deeper understanding of the subject matter. The teacher's role will be that of a facilitator. And there will be increasing dependence on information technology, new devices, online courses and online tools. Dyslexic persons will also be better supported through technology. By the way, there's an estimate that 10% of the population is dyslexic. So if there are 500 people here today, 50 of you are dyslexic. So, if you are not dyslexic, the person next to you has a 10% chance of being dyslexic. 10% is a conservative estimate. The teaching methods in future will depend on subject matter, class size, teachers' preference, facilities available, school or university. But in many situations, you can't beat traditional teaching methods. You don't use technology merely for the sake of using it, that's the bottom line. However, when you are in school or university, participation in sports and extracurricular activities is also important. It builds your character. You have to find a good balance. How you do that is up to you. And so my friends, my message today is simple, but I believe it is important. There will be increasing cycles of disruption, technological, social, economic and political. You must navigate through them by continuing learning throughout your working life. That is called lifelong learning. Lifelong learning.
We begin with the College Form Arts E-Prizes. The Gordon Buck Memorial Form Prize, called Arts E, HHS Seliratna. College Arts A, the TW Suryaraj Memorial Form Prize, KCK Pereira. The Reverend Beckett the Silver Memorial Prize, Divinity, EWBC Fernando. The Prize for Logic, KCK Pereira. The MPZ Silver Memorial Prize for Evidence in Political Science, MSRP. Dr. Miguel Vikramaraju Memorial Prize, Geography, H.M.M. Pereira. The Forest Soviet Secret Memorial Prize for Classics, Greek and Roman Civilization, N.S.R.B. The Winning Prize for Memorial Prize for History, H.M.N. Pereira. Prize for the Best Student in College Forms Arts A, K.C.K. Pereira. College Arts B, the Mr. and Mrs. Simon Adelikuma Memorial Form Prize, All Arts B, V.C. Tancun. The Lina Nantikazu Prize for Divinity, S.L. De Silva. The Mrs. H.M. Nantikazu Prize for Classics in Greek and Roman Civilizations, J.S. Cruz and D.A.T. Virakuri. The Mr. and Mrs. Edgar Diagas Memorial Prize for English, D.A.T. Virakuri. Justice George Randolph Kitsidas Vandanai for Memorial Prize, Elements in Political Science, S.L. De Silva. The C.P. Sanchez Mendes Prize for Geography, B.S.C. Dalmasena. The Winning Prize for Memorial Prize for History, M.N.I.S. Deshatriya. Prize for Logic, A.T.M.U.C.B. Cancun. The Dr. George Frederick Martinez Memorial Prize for the Best Student in College Forms Arts B, V.C. Cancun. College Form E-Commerce Prizes, Gordon Buck Memorial Form Prize, the Call Form Commerce E1, MRNA Rafiq, E2, KPMGE Pereira, E3, KA Fernando, and E4, AQM Marie. College Form A Commons, the D.C.W. Vikram Sekhar Memorial Form Prize for A1, D.M. Kamnaika. A2, S.R. Mukhanti. The P.D.R. Vikram Sekhar Memorial Form Prize for A3, G.H.S.S. Aridasa. The George R. De Silva Memorial Prize for Economics, S. Sivadarshan. The S.D.S. Taylor Memorial Prize for Business Studies, S. Ismail. The L.J.T.S. Telegraph Memory Prize for Accounts, S. Sivadarshan. College Form B, Comments. The Deshabandhu David Edwin Hetyarash Memory Form Prize for B1, M.P.A. Fernando. improve and repair our community. The Rubio Train out of Korea for the prize will be 3, C, and for Sima. The Royal Asiwada Memorial Prize Economics, B.S.C. Damisena. The Dr. and Mrs. Victor Hector Prize in Business Studies, R.S. Chenuratna. Professor Lakshman R. Butler Prize Accounts, C.N. Kurusinha. College Science E-Form Prizes. Science E1, J. Vikash. E2, N.Y. Ikansuria. E3, G.B. Ikansuria. The RSS Watson Memorial Prize of Physics, N.Y. Ikansuria. Prize Combined Mathematics, J. Vikash. The Dr. Anil N. Tribodan Memory Prize Biology, A. A. Asmi. The Priyanka Ramakrishna Memory Prize for Chemistry, N. Y. Ikamasuria. College Science A-Form Prizes, A1 S. Niroshan. A2 P. V. Balakrishnan. A3 U. K. M. Kemalai. The Warren Esther Anandamayo Memory Prize of Physics and Mathematics, the K.A.T. Apu Memory Prize of Physics, and the St. Gilbert Disorder Memory Prize of Chemistry, S. Niroshan. The Dr. and Mrs. L.E.J. Salgado Prize for Biology, D.E.M. Kulasinga. Prize Combined Mathematics, S. Niroshan. The Edward Everson Memory Prize for the best student in the College Form Science A, S. Niroshan. The John Wilson Memory Form Prize for B1, WMHC Kirasinghe. The ACG Reserva Memory Form Prize for B2, D.S. Carnivan. The Charlotte Reserva Memory Form Prize for B3, G.N.O. Vijayaratna. The Dr. Henry De Silva Headquarter Memorial Prize for Combined Mathematics, the Prize for Physics, the Prize for Combined Mathematics with Physics, and the Prize for Chemistry, D.S. Kangeevan. Dr. and Mrs. Ellen J. Sargard Prize Biology, the T.R. Aryanath Memorial Prize Biology with Chemistry, and the Prize Biology with Physics. G.M.O. Vijayaratnam. A.K.C. Sargard Memorial Prize to Best Student in College Form Science B. D.S. Khandeevan. Now to the Glasgow College Form A, A1 ASWG Gulankul. Prize accounts R. J. Kisera. Prize for Business Studies A. J. Nyenge. The late Mr. R. P. Mendes and the late Mrs. H. R. C. Mendes Prize for Economics, T. Vasant Kumar. Prize for English Professor, Alex White by Surya. The C. P. Function Mendes Prize Physics, A. S. W. G. Gulam Kumar. WRO and Indian Commando Memorial Prize for Chemistry and the C.P. Sanjay Mendes Prize for Mathematics, K.R. Paswangala. Prize for Further Mathematics, A.S.W.G. Gulankulam. Prize for Biology, K.R. Paswangala. Psychology, K.P.S. Fonseca. Prize for Law, S.Y. Surya. The Prize for Travel and Tourism, I.D. Jacinta Pereira. C.P. Sanjay Mendes Prize for the Best All-Round Student in the London Advanced Level College Forms A, A.S.W.G. Gulankulam. London Advanced Level College Forms B, B1 R.C.K. Kailamalika. B2 T.A.M. De Silva. The Raja Athiravan Memory Prize for Accounts L. Mendes. The Prize for Business Studies K.B.J.D.E. Kulavodhanam. Prize for Economics S.S. Arunkantan. Prize for English Professor in Memory of the Dora of Occasion, T.A.N. De Silva. The Mrs. C.W.S. Fernando Memorial Prize for Physics, R.C.K. Hale Monica. The Mr. and Mrs. T.A. Behadler Memorial Prize for Chemistry, R.C.K. Hale Monica. The R.B. Sirisena Memorial Prize for Mathematics, R. A. Vanagwakar. Prize for Further Mathematics, R. C. K. Kailamalika. The Board of the Lincoln Core Memorial Prize for Biology, R. A. Vanagwakar. Prize for apologies to KDJDE for the award. The Alex Jessen Memorial Prize for Best All-Round Student in the London Advanced Level College Holmes B, D.A.N. De Silva. The WKGN Pereira Memorial Form Prize for Upper 6A, James C. Pereira. Upper 6B, S.S. Gunawardena. Upper 6C, J.B.B. Ayeshan. Upper 6B, S. Dayaratna. Upper 6D, N.W.M.A. Hirasuriya. Upper 6F, BMC Vandivona. The Michael Arthur Ruffman Memorial Prize for Divinity, S. Daya Ruffman. The Squadron Leader, Shirang V. Pereira Memorial Prize for Buddhism, S.S. Gunawardena. The Kate Ganeshalinga Memorial Prize for Science, R. N. Pinod. Prize for Islam, M. I. Raji. The Hugh Jessinga Memorial Prize for English, J. C. Pereira. The H. S. Blyford Memorial Prize for Sinhala, S. Dayaratna. The next class will be Arisen Amukuru Prize for Singer and Professor, ICC Vipraveva. The Dr. B. Gedra Memorial Prize for Tamil and the Lloyd Gunawardena Memorial Prize for Mathematics, R. M. Pinoy. The J.W.F.H. Prince Memorial Prize for Science, S.S. Gunawardena. Prize for Science and Family Medium, R. M. Pinoy. English Medium, J. C. Pereira. Prize for History, S. Dayaratna. Prize for Civics, B. M. C. Vandivona. Mr. Lionel Sena Ruffman, Mrs. Millicent Sena Ruffman, and the Prize for Business Studies, S.S. Gunawardena. The J.W.F.H. Prince Memorial Prize for Information and Communication Technology, S.P.R. Fernando. The Subwarden Edmund St. Patrick Gunawardena Memorial Prize for English Language and English Literature. S.S. Gunawardena. The Lady Painter Memorial Prize for Art, T.B. Samasekar. The F.B. Kachanta Mendes Prize for Music, J.C. Pereira. The F.B. Vijay Wharton Memorial Prize for English Literature, S.S. Gunawardena. Tobias Dinner Memorial Prize for Best All-Round Student in the Upper Sixth Form, S.S. Gunawardena. Middle Sixth Form Prizes. The Reverend A.S.P. Gunawardena Memorial Form Prize for Middle Sixth A, R. Abhidhan. Middle 6B, L.K.P. Surakshit. Unit 6C, N. Pazalami. Unit 6B, H.A. Balaseka. Unit 6E, M. S. U. Fernando. Unit 6F, W. G. Tubby, Occasion. The JLDP is on their past dignity in Citizens Medium, N. S. Fernando. Tamil Medium, S. C. Sunil Medium. The S.H. Mahathir Ulvela Memorial Prize for Buddhism, D.R. Dodamke Kanga. By Simonson, we pledge. Mr. Sifri Latifa, Sanctuary Memorial Prize for Islam, A.J. Kofi. The Kevin Morrison Memorial Prize for English, R. American. Roshan Arida Memorial Prize for Similar, Vinay Karasuri Arisen Award Prize for Similar Prefecture, D.R. Pradampe Chama. The E.S. Kalashan Memorial Prize for Tamil, R. Avirtan. The Rasaya Memorial Prize for Mathematics, D. Vinesh. The J.P. Manika Sinha Memorial Prize for Science in the Finland Museum, W.O.J. Fonseca. Tamil Medium, N. Abhilton. English Medium, G.A.B.B. Arashu. The Northern Murray Prize for History, R. Abhilton. Prize for Civics, S.S. Kitarashi. Prize for Business Studies, Similar and English Medium, A.L. Vikramadilakar. Tamil Medium, M. Padmavadman. W.C.L. Fernando Memorial Prize for Information and Communication Technology, N.S. Fernando. The Murtia A.C.G.S. Undersecretary Memorial Prize for Art, H.R.B. Fernando. The Reverend L.C.G. Fernando Memorial Prize for Music, R. Amitan. The N.S.J. Rukumarathi Memorial Prize for English Professor, K.D. Munasimha and S.S. Sarachi. The Subwarden Orwin Abhimaka Memorial Prize for the best all-round students in the middle sixth form, R. Abhitan. The Sir Sangrapilli Pararaj Singh Memorial Form Prize for Lower 6A, P.V.V.E. Pereira. Lower 6B, H.R.H. Pierce. Lower 6C, A.P.M. Karmaratman. Lower 6B, R. Ilan Poodman. Lower 6E, D. Yuchan. Lower 6F, D.D. Evenly. The Canon W.H.W. Tri-Secular Memorial Prize, Divinity, P.D.D.D. Pereira. Prize for Islam, A.M. Samad. I'm Kannada Sabe Kuru Memorial Prize Buddhism, ATM Kannada Fund. We have Venice in the Tangi Memorial Prize Science and Jean Astrid. The first of the prize for English, HRH Phoenix. The Nagin Commander Prize for Sinhala, KKN Medjunker. Prize for Tamil, R. Nampudman. The RASK Kanada Kudasim Commander Prize for Mathematics. Also R. Lampoon. The Prize for Science, A.D.M. Karnaratna. The G.F.P. Bandar Memorial Prize for History, H.R.H. Peters. The Prize for Indian Languages in Tamil, K.K.N. McNuka. The David Aryabhatta Memorial Prize for Music, P.D.D.D. Pereira. Professor Nani Trasco Memorial Prize for Art, U.L.S.W. Kunasinghe. Prize for English Literature in memory of Mrs. Dora Bukeju, A.Z. Chitti. The Dr. D.J. Aryabhatta Memorial Prize for the Best All-Round Student in the Lotus Form, H.R.H. Pierce.
Middle School, 5th Form, the A.G. Sinhavani Memorial Form Prizes, Form 5A, H.S. Gunasinghe. Form 5B, C.D. Vijayapala. Form 5C, W.S.N. Pereira. Form 5E, M.U. Hassanji. Form 5E, S.P. Dimel. And Form 5F, A.T.M. Zubair. The Bishop's Prize for Divinity, S.P. Dimel. Mr. and Mrs. David Kodipaka Prize for Buddhism, N.A.M.M.S. Nanakara. Prize for Islam, M.U. Hassindi. The Colonel R. Kumaranayaka Memorial Prize for Sadhism, S. Asvedan. The Meridianakum Memorial Prize for English, S.P. Dimel. The Cyril de Silva Memorial Prize for Sinhala, M.U. Hassidri. The Dr. J. Gabriel Memorial Prize for Tamil and the J.P. Salgado Senior Memorial Prize for Mathematics, C. Tuvamaran. Prize for Science, A. Sananyan. Prize for History, A.D.M. Zuhair. For the Denaling Zansuria Memorial Prize for Art, C.D. Vijayapala. The S.R.S. Henry's Memorial Prize for Music, Y.A. Atupala. Prizes for his candidate, Singhala M.N.A. Atman, and Tamil M.U. Kasindi. The Devendra Kandaya Memorial Prize for the Best All-Round Boy in Form 5, M.U. Kasindi. The C.P. Sanjay Mendes Prize for the Most Improved Student in the Middle School, J.J.W. Delayer. The Reverend Canon Charles Thomas Memorial Form Prizes, Upper 4A, K.D. Gurahinavikarana. Upper 4B, K.D.T.T. Gurarakya. Upper 4C, W.M.S.D. Bandara. Upper 4D, M.G.S. Fernando. Upper 4E, WMIU, Veera Singha. Upper 4-5, TDP Rubero. The Arthur Irene Pidruja Wadman Memorial Prize for Dignity, S.J. Vijay Singha. The L.D. Kumasuri Memorial Prize for Buddhism, K.D.T.D. Gunaratna. Prize for Islam, J. Ahmed. Prize for Sayyidism, S. Dakshinadayan. The Lutheran is his group presenting the Memorial Prize for English, J.D.N. Morris. The other Chileco Asam Memorial Prize for Senior Language, M.G.S. Fernando. The P. Satyanandan Memorial Prize for Tamil, P. Lakshitan. The Roland Rivera Tenetwood Memorial Prize for Mathematics, S.J. Vijay Singha. The Nalik Fernando Prize for General Science, H.A. Amar Jeda. The late Dr. C.V.X.R. Vidho Babapure Memorial Prize for Social Studies, WMIU Veera Singha. The Veer Govindar J.R. Surya Bandar Memorial Prize for Art, T.D.P. Rubero. The Reverend Lucian J.P. Fernando Memorial Prize for Music, S.J. Vijay Singha. Prize for Lead Languages, Singhala R.S. Sandeep and Tamil M.G.S. Fernando. The Ganeshwara Memorial Prize for the Best All-Round Student in the Upper Fourth Form, K.D.T.D. Gunaratna. Lower Fourth Form, the Paul and Joyce Kinnatilaka Memorial Form Prizes, Lower Fourth A, S.N. Kalan Surya. Lower Fourth B, Tim Pekashainan. Lower 4C, A. Eaton. Lower 4D, T. R. Sandivakna. Lower 4D, T. Ishan. Lower 4F, P. E. Fernando. The Canon W. H. Chaisekar Memorial Prize for Divinity, P. E. Fernando. The Jamal J. Hamid Maritha Memorial Prize for Islam, M.S. Sadat. The Colonel R. Kumar Nair Memorial Prize for Sadism, T. Kishan. The T. Justin Peeris Memorial Prize for Buddhism, S. N. Kalansuya. Prize for English, J. K. Ferdinando. The Charles D. S. Ranadeva Memorial Prize for Sinhala, S.A.M.A.L.U. Agaryavana. Prize for Tamil, K. Abhishka. The B. Cook Memorial Prize for Mathematics, P. E. Fernando. The Prize for Science, J.B.C. Pires. The Warwick Theatre Davidson Memorial Prize for Art, S.N. Jayamala. Prize for Lake Languages, Sinhala, T. Kishan. And Tamil, P. E. Fernando. The Carl De Vera Memorial Prize for the Best All-Round Student in the Level 4 Form, P. E. Fernando. Nurse School, Upper Third Form, the Doreen Patricia Gunaratna Hinson Memorial Form Prizes, Upper 3CA, G.S. Rajiv. Upper 3E, L.D.N. De Silva. Upper 3C, R.J. Sanitetan. Upper 3D, S. K. Dharan. Upper 3E, D.B. Dishanayaka. Upper 3F, D.K.H. Varanagay. The Arthur Lambert Memorial Prize for Divinity, D.T. Dishanayaka. The G.L. Dinadas Memorial Prize for Buddhism, K.D.S. Pereira. The N. Yusuf Santidi Memorial Prize for Islam, N.A. Mohammed Nawaz. Prize for Sadism, U. Venushan. The Margaret Pereira Memorial Prize for English, A.A.T. Marika. The Dr. F.C. Gomez Memorial Prizes for Language, Sinhala, R.N.R. Kandaka. Tamil, H. Dharminder. Prize for English Recitation, G.S. Rajiv. Prize for Sinhala Recitation, M.G.R.Y. Ranasingha. Prize for Tamil Recitation, V. Varangaran. Prize for Mathematics, R.J. Sainthetan. The D.C. Kalasahan Memorial Prize for Environmental Studies, D.K.H. Baranagay. The Model Peers Memorial Prize for Art, D.P. Darniagala. The Noel Vijayaratna Memorial Prize for Singing, S.J. Kure. By Barnabas Memorial Prize for the best all-round student in the upper K form, G.S. Raji. The C.P. Sanjayanis Prize for the most improved student in the Love School, D.R. Madhavala. Lower third form. The Chidan Ishan Fernando Memorial Form Prizes, Lower 3A, D.B. Udamalagar. Lower 3B, M.H.P. Ture. Lower 3C, K.D. Vaji Kunaratna. Lower 3D, S.C.R. Mendes. Lower 3E, P.N.D. Fernando. The Reverend Brian and Mr. Raji Kriman Memorial Prize for Divinity, S.C.R. Mendes. The S.E. Fernando Memorial Prize for Buddhism, M.H.D. Kure and K.D. Vaji Narasana. The M. Yusuf Santidi Memorial Prize for Islam, M.J. Abdi. Prize for Sadism, S. Shyamalan. The J.H.S. Fields Memorial Prize for English, H.L. Bhumesh Surya. Mrs. K. Bandaratilaka Memorial Prize for Sinhala, C.R.M. Pereira. Prize for Tamil, R. Sivanath. The Jim Sonarat Memorial Prize for Mathematics, C.R.M. Pereira. Prize for Art, R.N.H. Sivakumar. The Hara Mahanaraja Memorial Prize for Singing, G.C. Peeris. Prize for English Recitation, A.C.S. Varnasuriya. Prize for Sinhala Recitation, K.D. Vaidhi Gunaratna. Prize for Tamil Recitation in memory of Mr. Bhakti Sri Fernando, I. Abhishwasan. Special prizes. The Bishop's Senior Divinity Prize, G.S.N. Pereira. The Archdeacon F.H. Vigington Memorial Prize for Liturgy, K.Y.K. Senaratna. The Canon John Foster Memorial Prize for Church History, G.S.N. Pereira. The other level of Memorial Prize for Dignity Month is here. G. Hanshavadhanan. The Roger and Gary Singer Memorial Choir Prize, S.E.J. Daniel. The Rosebud Bandaranath Memorial Choir Prize Senior, S.J. Gentlemany. The Fred Edward Singer Memorial Choir Prize Junior, Y.D.P. Gulab Singh Alagay. The Sub-Warden Patrick Warden Memorial Prize for the Leader of the Choir, A.R. Summersinger. Prize for Member of the Choir, T.S.D.K. Pierce. The Sub-Warden Order of the National Memorial Choir Prize for the Most Promising Trevor, C.D.M. Jairaktan. Choir Prize for Attendance, N.S. Fernando. Prize for Reading the Lesson in Chapel in Memory of Lambert William Isaac Fernando, S.B.L. de Moria. The Bishop Harold Program Memorial Prize for Senior Sacristan, W.M. White. Memorial Prize for the Server Senior, D.G. White. The Sub-Warden for the Abinite Memorial Prize for Server Junior, Y.D. Lanero. The Canon R.S. Museum Prize for Comparative Vision, K.Y.K. Sena Ratna. The E.S. Herrera Memorial Prize for Mathematics Junior, S. Axweber. The Board E.F. Miller Memorial Prize for Mathematics and the Prize for Mathematics, J. Vikash. The S.B. Sutter-Singer Memorial Prize for Mathematics in the College Form, G. Hanshavadhanan. The Lloyd Gordon Memorial Prize for Science in the College Form, G. D. Gunasekara. The Sheldon Kotaki Giant Trust the student with the best performance at the Inter-School Software Competition, T.S.M. Pierce. Information and Communication Technology Prize, Middle Sixth Form, upwards, P. Dhananjay. The Board of C.H.L. Davidson Memorial Prize for College History, A.D.M. Karuna Ratna. The D.R. Vijay Bodhman Memorial Prize for Political History of Sri Lanka, P. Junasingha. The Dr. John Kamal Kuna Memorial Prize for Knowledge of Current Affairs and Politics, N.S. Arifi. The Richard DeSouza Memorial Prize for English Composition, K.Y.K. Sena Ratna. The Arts Memorial Prize for English Literature, T.A.N. De Silva. The P.D.C. Award for English Composition, P.D. Fernando. The R.F.A. Mendes Memorial Prize for English, C.I.S. Pereira. English, K.Y.K. Senaratna. The Roger Madison Memorial Prize for English Poetry, K.R. Bhatwangala. The Edward Winter Madison Memorial Prize for English Grammar, S.P. Jimel. The Rosie M. A. Gabby Frederick Senaratna Memorial Prize awarded to the editor of the college magazine, T.G. White. The Samson and Silva Pen Mother's Office for the Interhouse Gender College, please. Woodhouse. The Warden Stone Memorial Prize for Classics, Greek and Roman Civilization in College for Arts, N.K.L. Peter. The W.M.L. Martinez Memorial Prize for Western Classics, A. Masekara. The P.P. Sanjay Mendes Prize for Sinhala, S.C. Sahabandhu. The Great Mudaliya and M. Namoda Memorial Prize for Tamil, R. Vainovich. The K.C. Connor Seven P.C. Memorial Award for Tamil Literature, P. Abhimanyu. The Lal Rodrigo Memorial Prize for Knowledge of General Current Affairs, H.D.E.H. Vijayananda. The Sub-Warden F.J. Senaratna Memorial Prize for General Knowledge, K.A.M. Kamal Chandra. Prize for History, P. Durusimha. The Metropolitan Laboratory Memorial Prize for Natural History, Senior, W.N.H.C. Virasimha. The Don Igunasekar Memorial Prize for Natural History, Junior, J.A. Gulatsinghala. The Mike Ilanapur Memorial Prize for the Improvement of the Environment and the Mr. and Mrs. H.K.A. Kurgan Memorial Prize for a Short Story in English, R.C.K. Hevamalika. The Ilanapur Memorial Prize for Oratory, Sinhala, K.C.K. Pereira. The S.J. Gunasekaran Memorial Prize for Oratory in Tamil and the Sarath Muthulegama Memorial Prize for Oratory, English and Sinhala and or English and Tamil, N. Ganeshian. The W.R.O. Fernando Memorial Prize for the Best Debater in Sinhala, K.C.K. Pereira. Prize for the Best Debater in Tamil, N. Ganeshian. Sir Sandra Pindey Paraj Singham Memorial Prize for the Best Debater in English, S.J. Rajanandan. J. Adish. The ALM and NBC Fernando Memorial Trophy for the Best Scrabble Player, H.A.J. Vijay Singha. the G.C. Gunavardhan Shari Memorial Prize for the Senior Cadet, RRMU Ratnayakar. Trophy for Special Merit for the Senior Cadet in memory of Rajiv K. Surya, A.U. Ramukpada. The Wing Commander to win a Kalwarashi Memorial Trophy to the most outstanding senior cadet, S.R. Udamalavada. The David R. Malak Memorial Prize for an outstanding cadet with good record for studies and discipline, MKHG Maya Singha. The EDB Ramanayaka Challenge Trophy for Intersection Training, GGL Nuan. The Board of Captain C.H. Davidson CCB Memorial Prize for Marksmanship Senior, S.L. Nihin Kadwa. The Arthur Abhisekam Memorial Trophy for Efficiency in Scouting, P. Ajit. The A.L. Victor Memorial Prize for the Best Scout, B.C.C.G. De Silva and W.H.S. Fernando. Prize for the Best Junior Scout in memory of Mr. W.H. Pereira, KMGH Kulatuka. The National Silver Medal Trophy for the Most Promising Junior Scout, BDMA Jayasinghe. The Johnson Planet Cup is led by Junior. Prize for the most outstanding cup, first prize, G.S. Raji. Second prize, S.G.S. Anthony. The Sats and Disturba Tenemar Memorial Trophy to the Best Actors, C.I.S. Pereira and S.D.S. Sansoni. Ladies and gentlemen, owner bearing car number 301-4439, I repeat, 301-4439, please remove your car as it's blocking an entrance. The Reverend Canon Roy Lee Memorial Prize for an outstanding actor with notable academic achievement, W.M. White. The Lewis A.P.P. Aries Piranevalam Memorial Challenge Cup for Senior Tennis, B. Fernando. The Challenge Cup for Junior Tennis, R. Ratnasinghe. The Bharti Gunatilaka Memorial Prize for the Best Performance at the Ceylon School's Tennis Meet Seniors, A.A. Pereira. trophy for table tennis in memory of the late Honorable Narayanan Ellavara, A.L. Vikramathilaka. The challenge trophy for the best badminton player of the year, L. Nedis. Trophy for the most outstanding hockey player, HBKJ Pires. The shield for the most promising hockey player in memory of Ranil Abhinayaka. Senior, R.B. Nanda Perma. The Jonathan de Fonseca Memorial Trophy for the most outstanding basketball player, A.S. Sunavardhana. The trophy for the leader of the Hazy Band, B. Karalyaka. The trophy for the best D.E. Gunawardana and M.D.S. Fernando. The trophy for the most promising senior bandsman, B.D. Yangavi. The trophy for the best junior batsman, PVDP Pereira. The trophy for the band leader, HLBP Bastian. The trophy for the leader of the orchestra, HLBP Bastian. The trophy for the most promising junior orchestral player, R. Abirkan. The trophy for the most promising senior orchestra player, S.J. Jeverman. The CSPS Sandy Ratna Memorial Prize for the Oldsman with Best Recording Work and Games, Senior M.K.L. Peter. To the Oldsman with Best Record in Work and Games Junior Under 16, R.W.A.N.D. Rajaguru. The Challenge Shield for Swimming, N.A.J. Ingrua. The Monica Saravan Muttu Challenge Cup for the Best Junior Swimmer, A. Sauja. The Dr. R.L. Heyman Memorial Trophy for Diving, S.Y.S. Anthony. Trophy for the Best Rugrat of the Season, N.L. Heyman. Trophy for an outstanding outstanding pressure of the first 15 rugby in memory of our respected rugby coach, teacher and their master, H.A.R. Senanayake. In memory of Shamil Manojit Jinsena for junior rugby with best record in games and work, J.D. D'Souza. The David R. Haddock Memorial Scholarship Prize for a senior rugby with the best record in work and games, S. Jayatilaka.
Thank you.
The board never graduates the Nobel Prize for best results at the GCE ordinary level examinations 2015. C.N. Gurusingha. and J.F. Mandel. Prize for the all-round boy in the upper school, S. Dharatna. The Dr. Arnold Lehman Memorial Trophy to the best all-round boy among the college holders, L.A.D.K.M. Pereira. The Dr. Lakshman Lekawasan Memorial Prize for the student with the best A-level results in the biological science stream, G.D. Gunasekara. Memorial Shield for the best advanced level results in the math stream, Jake Picard. The Professor PGGS awards the Memorial Prize to the student with the best London advanced level results, S.M. Gunaratna. Memorial Prize for the first and second best performance at the GCE Advanced Level Examination. First, J. Vikash. Second, M. Y. Vikramasuriya. The JLD Davis Memorial Prize for the best student in College Forms, Arts and Science. K.H.A.S. Arya Ratna, J. Vikash, and H.H.S. Selvi Ratna. The Admiral H.A. Silva, PhD Challenge Trophy for the best all-round student in academics and sports, D.A. Francis. Anandanayan Memorial Prize for the best all-round sportsman, S. Jayatilaka. The Boys Team Challenge Cup for the most promising junior sportsman of the year, under 16, K.T. Kulasimha. Merge with a sacred memorial prize for the best all-round student who has qualified to enter university in Sri Lanka. P. Jadushan. The Sarangapuram Prize, awarded to a student demonstrating early promise of exhibiting human excellence and virtue in adult life, to commemorate a distinguished Soviet family. L.S. Bartlett. The Christian Dialogist Selvi Ratna Memorial Trophy for an academic achievement during the year, J. Vikash. Gold medal for the best all-round student, D.A. Francis.
chief guest this evening, Professor Kripanta Mendis, members of the clergy, members of the Board of Governors, one, members of staff, distinguished invitees, prize winners, students, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed an honor and a privilege to stand before you this evening to propose the vote of thanks to our chief guest. Having wandered around for the first 11 years of his life, looking for the right school, Professor Mendis found his way to St. Thomas's College, Montalegre in 1955 and remained here as a student until 1962. Thereafter, his accomplishments in the field of engineering being too numerous to be impossible to mention here. I am though, however, informed that Professor Mendis's maternal grandfather and great-grandfather, both having been Methodist ministers, he too was expected to follow suit. However, having pursued engineering myself, sir, I believe you have chosen wisely. Although the two distinguished gentlemen on either side of you might very well disagree. Your display of innovative thinking to make even the mundane task of having a morning shave to be elevated to the levels of a Japanese tea ceremony is beyond our comprehension. But you are well known in your quest for excellence, heightened experiences, and quality of life, which undoubtedly would have inspired many generations of those who were fortunate to have been your students. Thank you, sir, for gracing this occasion and being an inspiration to all our students. And I hope that one day, they too may be able to follow in your footsteps. This evening, you have the added responsibility of giving out the majority of the prizes, which undoubtedly was no easy task. Many thanks also to the Lord Bishop for joining Professor Mendis in distributing the prizes. It is always a proud day when we are able to celebrate and rejoice in the accomplishments of our students. The prize giving would not have been possible if it wasn't for the dedication and commitment of one special lady who came into her office every day during the holidays in December to type the vouchers and to finalize the prize list. To Mrs. Priya Adams, we owe a debt of gratitude. Your hard work, madam, is greatly appreciated. I would also like to say a word of thanks to all those who helped behind the scenes to make this event a success. They are too numerous to mention, but my sincere thanks to all of them for their hard work and dedication. Lastly, to the prize winners, well done in your achievement. You have put in a lot of hard work, and this is your reward. To those who didn't make it, do remember that this is not the end. Strive always to achieve greater heights, whether in school or after leaving school. Never cease to achieve excellence in everything you do. Thank you. God bless you. Esther Papetra.
Chief Guest from Kripanta Mendis, volunteer, sub-volunteer, chaplain, associate chaplain, members of the Board of Governors, tutorial and administrative staff, distinguished invitees, parents, and my fellow Thomians. First of all, I would like to thank my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ for giving me this wonderful opportunity to second the word of thanks as the head prefect of SCC. Last year, the board stated that 2016 has been a very special year for us. Truly, it has been a significant year, as we received the best ever results in the history of St. Thomas's College. College also excelled at sporting events, winning all domain encounters in rugby, water polo, tennis, sailing, and football. Just as every year has its ups and downs, we have also experienced loss, failure, and disappointment. While we cherish the memories of these victories, the times of adversity we face will remain strongly with us. My Lord Bishop, at our World Installation 2015, you stressed the fact that St. Thomas' College is a Christian school based on Christian values. This statement truly appealed to me. Thus, my prefects and I took the initiative to give thanks to the Almighty and accept each other as one. We are bound by a brotherhood which lasts for a lifetime. Therefore, I would like to take this opportunity to thank my Lord Bishop for insisting on the importance of these true values. Today, we are honored and privileged to have with us this evening our chief guest, Dr. Krishanda Mendis, for our annual prize giving. The prize giving must have been an event with which Dr. Mendis was quite familiar back in his school days. Fortunately for us though, he is here not to take away 9 out of 10 prizes as he did during his school days, but is here to hand them over to young prize winners. Professor Mendis was well known in his school days for excelling in academics. He dreamt of being an engineer, but he ended up being a lecturer. He has lectured at the University of Peradeniya and thereafter at the National University of Singapore. Sir, you serve as a symbol that emphasizes the vitality of a holistic education. I trust that STC played an important role in imparting the discipline required to recognize and uphold one's priorities. During his period at the engineering faculty of the University of Colombo, Professor Mendis was transferred to the University of Peradeniya. Having been brought up in Colombo, his transfer to an unfamiliar environment made traveling uphill and back to Colombo rather a tedious task. However, after a few weeks, the boys used to study on weekdays and come down to weekends. But unlike others, one of the senior lecturers had found out something unusual about young Krishanda Mendis. Professor Krishanda used to spend 5 days of the week in Colombo and went to Peradeniya only on weekends for his studies. Only God knows why such a bright student followed this procedure. But I am told that he always knew his priorities. Professor Krishanda was never ashamed to be identified as a true Thomian. He would specially sing the college song at CCYM camps. He did so to show the true qualities the Thomian possesses, which is to be staunch and to be true, and to catch the attention of the fair agenda. Sir, thank you for inspiring young Thomians like me to follow in the path of a great gentleman such as yourself. I would like to take this opportunity to thank all those who have been instrumental in making this annual prize giving a great success. Thank you for your hard work and commitment. It's a famous quote, hard work pays off. Hard work indeed needs to be rewarded. Professor Krishanda, while you have reached great heights, I'm sure you know what disappointment is all about. I presume that one of your disappointments may have been in not producing a Thomian to carry on your legacy. Having faced such disappointment, sir, I am sure you wouldn't want to disappoint 2,700 boys by failing to convince the warden in declaring Monday a holiday. Don't worry, sir. In my view, Monday being a holiday will not cause any disruption. However, a boy was not on the cards at your second opportunity either. Double the trouble for you, sir, because this club has been a request that you grant Tuesday a holiday as well. Sir, that was a perfectly fit time late card for you. Meanwhile, Warren, sir, as a member of the batch, has produced the best advanced level result in the history of the school. It is my duty on behalf of my batch to request that you grant Wednesday holiday to commemorate this achievement. As a 19th born of college, who had 88 students obtaining 3 years, you, Warren, sir, have the privilege to be the first born to reward students with a double holiday. In addition, there is always a saying, behind every successful man is a woman that never gave up. There is also a saying that behind every successful student is a teacher that never gave up. For the tireless efforts made by our dear teachers to guide our young students to reach their true potential, I appeal to you, Father, on behalf of our dear teachers, to grant them half day on Thursday for their dedication and hard work. But since pride is a foyer, it wouldn't be productive for the support staff just to come to school to open the classroom for 3 periods. So you might want to grant the full day off for the entire staff. As it does not make any sense for students to be present without teachers in class, I suggest that Thursday too be declared a school holiday. To my class of 2016, I wish I could speak to all of you. We have done our college proud. We have done well in academics and in sports. For the future generations of SDC, as I've always stated, success begets success. I hope that all of you will carry on the Thomian legacy which has existed thus far. To conclude, may I take this opportunity to thank Prof. Tushar Mendes for attending our annual prize giving. I would like to also thank all stakeholders of our prestigious school, a school that provides holistic education and strives to produce men of integrity and true gentlemen to serve this nation. Finally, there are 2 things in this world, the possible and the impossible. We do what's possible, strive for the impossible, and let God handle the rest. Thank you, God bless you all, Esso Perpetua.
I'm reading from my script. I don't have a typepad printer here, so this is. Mr. Warren, sir, may I implore you to continue with the tradition of giving usual Monday holiday and perhaps to enhance the tradition to cover Tuesday as well. One day for your speech and Tuesday for mine.